Bye, everyone. Thank you so much for coming. So as Jenny mentioned, we're going to be talking about how to organize and prioritize while working in Clio Manage. Thank you also to our visionary partners. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Zoe Haber. I'm an account executive, which just means that I do all of the product demonstrations for those who do not yet have Clio. Hi to those of you I've met so far. Hello to all of you, those that I have not met, but it's nice to officially meet you all. I just want to start off with a quick story here. My sister got married about 5 years or so ago, and it was honestly the most amazing example of organization, prioritization, and execution. There were so many moving things, all that fun stuff. And honestly, to the untrained eye, it seemed like pure chaos. From the wedding, from the flowers, to the food, to the songs, to the dancing, it was executed amazingly. But that's because they had a wedding planner with a plan. She had a plan to organize, prioritize, so the wedding could have the most amazing execution. If planning a wedding is even slightly as chaotic as running a law firm, we need to make sure that you guys are organized from the second you get started. Just to go over our agenda here, if everything goes according to plan, we're going to spend about 5 minutes on organization, 5 minutes on prioritization, final 5 minutes on execution. Quick question for you guys. How many of you are legal professionals by choice? Okay. How many of you feel like you are a therapist, but not by choice? Awesome. That's what I figured you'd say. Well, essentially, you guys are wearing so many different hats. So we need to make sure that when you're running your law firms and working in Clio Manage, that it is as easy as possible. So we're just going to start by showing you having your amazing intake specialist plug a new client into Clio Manage so we can get organized right away. How many of you have set up a contact in Clio Manage before? Okay, so we won't go do such a deep dive in there. What I want to do is actually bring your focus to the importance of custom fields and how custom fields lead to organization within the firm. Custom field sets in particular are the key to organization. We want to make sure that if your intake specialist gets any scenario, that they get all of the appropriate information. What is the benefit of having a set? Well, let's say one day your intake specialist leaves. We want to make sure that whoever is there the next minute can still get that important information, regardless of who's answering the phone and who's speaking with the client. New people happen all the time. We want to make sure that it's a smooth experience for both your firm, having that internal transition, but also for the client. We need to make sure that client experience is amazing from the beginning to the end. So for those of you who raised your hand for creating a contact, can I just assume that y'all have also created a matter as well? Okay, perfect. Well, your intake specialist is likely going to be adding in that client, and they're going to be assigning the attorney. Some of you may not know this, but the practice area actually determines the stages of the matter. We're going to head into matter stages in about 2 minutes briefly, but what I really want to focus on is custom fields, which again are critical to organization for both setting up a contact and also setting up a matter. In this situation, we're going to use a criminal template. So for all those criminal attorneys, I'm sure I might be doing this wrong. Please give me that feedback. How many of you have practiced one area of law? How many of you practiced two areas of law? How many of you would consider yourselves as having a general practice? Okay, I was expecting more hands, so that's okay, though. I consider myself as having a general practice in my fake law firm. The key here is that your intake specialist needs to be set up for success no matter what area of law or what type of matter is coming into your firm. Picture a new client calls in. They have a DUI. Your intake specialist, if there's just one area of law and all you deal with are DUIs, they're going to have that standard information that they need to get. But maybe you also do theft. Maybe you also do divorces. Maybe you do adoptions. How can your intake specialist possibly remember all of that different information that they need to get all the time? Well, that's why we have custom field sets. That's why we need to make it so easy. There's so much different information, so many steps.
custom fields are key for practice areas. They're going to make your intake specialist life so much easier. Also, if you're the attorney, you're the legal assistant, you're the paralegal, and you're also the intake specialist, we need to make that as easy as possible. Finally, your intake specialist is going to be selecting that billing preference, but we're going to hand off this matter with a task list. We're going to get into task lists in a few minutes, and then we're also going to get into those matter stages. Just want to give you a brief preview here of how all that information is actually entered into the matter. Going to go in, show you that task. Going to give you just a quick view on how that task list shows. There are multiple people involved in this matter. So many things going on. But task lists are key to organizing that work. We want to make sure that the managing partner, if y'all are here, you guys need to have peace of mind knowing that your clients and their matters are going to be taken care of no matter what. The steps that need to be taken first are going to be prioritized. The important stuff matters. Getting all that organized matters. So now we've created our matter. We've set up our custom fields. We've viewed a task list. Now we're going to get into prioritizing our work in Clio Manage. We're going to take a deeper dive into creating those lists because task lists are key to prioritization, and so are those matter stages. We're going to go over a task list here. It's going to be pretty much the same for the next four slides, but all of the roles and responsibilities for the client are going to change. Having lists set up in advance are going to increase efficiency. We're going to have a better client relationship. We're going to have a better firm relationship, and everyone's just going to have a better experience. We want to make sure that no task, no matter how big, how small, slips through the cracks. Just by creating my first task here, we have to name it. I'm sure you guys have done that before. And of course, we need to set the priority. Is it low, normal, high? Have to give it that description. Next, we're going to assign it. I'm going to show you those different options on what we can do just after this. We're going to have a trigger date. Some of you may not know, trigger date is essentially, do I need to wait for a certain task to be completed before the next one happens? Do I need to wait 10 days after a task has been completed for the next one to happen? Or does it just need to happen on a certain date? And then we get into those reminders because everyone needs to be reminded differently and we all have different ways of remembering things. I'm changing this one to be intake. We're changing the priority. We're changing the description once again. This assignee that I'm choosing here is actually going to be based on select. So when I assign this task list to the matter, at that point, I'm going to assign who needs to do that task. But in other scenarios, you might just know when you set up the task list from the get-go that such and such people are going to always do that task. Reminders for me, I like email, so I'm going to choose that one as well. And then lastly, we're going to do this one as our arrests. This one is high priority. This has to be the most important one. Our description has to be different. I know it may seem pretty basic, setting up a task list, everything should be different, but it really needs to be different. We need to make sure that no one is getting confused or tasks are similar. Again, we're using a different trigger date. Now I've chosen to use our list assignee. So we have those options in place. And then I had my reminders. So now you can see our task list that we've created. We have arrest records. We have call the client. We have due intake. And all of this just comes together and it can only be improved and improved and improved. If you were just here for matter stages, this is going to be fresh in your mind. For those of you who were not, matter stages are critical for prioritization and organization within a firm. On average, attorneys are billing about 2.5 hours for the work that they're actually doing in an 8-9 hour, probably 18 hour day if we're being realistic. And the goal of Clio is we need to make sure that number of billing is as high as possible. There are no guessing games in the legal industry. We need to make sure that everyone is up to date on all matters all the time. If a client calls in, we need to get them that information. We need to have it at our fingertips. I'm sure a lot of you are bogged down with work right now, and this cannot be part of what's bogging you down. This is going to make your life easier. We need to know what are we going to prioritize. Let's have a quick peek here. Going to look at my matter stages. Just heading into matter, clicking stages. I'm going to start with my divorce matters here, and you can see we have all of the different stages and different matters within that. Heading into personal injury, I have a different set of stages. different matters. Some of these stages might be pretty similar, but there are definitely going to be major differences as well, whether it's personal injury, is it a criminal case, is it a divorce? And that's why matter stages matter. Lastly, just going to show you that criminal matter that we created earlier. We had it started in the investigation stage, and as this case matter progresses, we're going to see it move through that. Now that we've finished organizing and prioritizing our work in Clio Manage, we're going to switch gears. We're going to talk, of course, we're going to keep talking about custom fields because that's why we're here, but we're going to talk about how custom fields also allow you to execute your work. We're going to head over to the personal dashboard, the firm dashboard, and then we're also going to go highlight how everything that you set in place is what's allowing you to execute the work properly. We're going to go to all of our matters. I'm sure this is a familiar page for all of you. We can see all of our matters. Lots of firms take advantage, though, of filtering those matters by custom fields. So being able to get into a smaller, more concise list so that everything isn't just in front of you, kind of messy, is really helpful. How small did that list become just by using a custom field? How long did it take me? It probably took me longer to actually use this than it would have if I had just done it on my computer. How does the personal dash look to you? On the left-hand side, we have our tasks. On the right-hand side, we have our calendar. Below, we have those personal financial metrics. I just want to show you the left dot beside our tasks. Red dot means overdue. Let's just quickly go back to our tasks. At the bottom here, you'll notice we actually have a task that is outstanding. It's for the matter we created. But one important thing is it actually says, how long is this task going to take us to complete? Looks like it's going to take about an hour. So let's head back to our personal dashboard and see, where are we going to fit it in? So looks like we have a brief at 9 a.m. We have lunch at 12. We have a very nice day. So we can probably just put in that outstanding task in between 9 and 12. All of this is so important because with everything you set in place, that's how you can schedule your day. We need to start our morning by figuring out a plan of execution. Now, if you're the managing partner, if you're the office manager, if you're the bookkeeper, you may be driven to start your day on the firm dashboard, not the personal dashboard. And this is where we have our financial metrics. There are so many numbers here. I do not expect you to know what they mean, but they're important. That's what matters. We have our utilization rate. Our utilization rate is the number of billable hours worked divided by the number of hours in a workable day. So how much time that we're recording are we actually billing for? Let's make that number high. Realization rate. It's a measure of value efficiency. Out of that billable work, what are you actually billing for? Even if it's a flat rate, if it's taking you 3 hours to do something, that should take you an hour, that's a problem. And we need to be able to look into those metrics and figure out how can the firm do better? What are we missing? How can we make this 1 hour task take 2 hours if it's taking 3 hours? How can we cut it down to 30 minutes? What can we do? What is holding us back? Collection rate. I'm going to say our favorite number here. Should be everyone else's favorite. The number of hours collected divided by the number of hours invoiced. All of these metrics are so important. They're different. They're kind of similar, but they build us that big picture. Want to give you a quick recap here. We've gone over a lot of things, but we've gone over organization and prioritization. How do we do that in Clio Manage? Well, the key to doing those things is by using custom fields. People come to you first. They're going to choose your law firm first. Why? Because your clients have amazing experiences with you. From the day they call you to the day they say goodbye, and of course, they're likely going to call you again because you did so well. Our time is basically up. But I just want to say thank you to everyone for coming. QR code right there. If you want to scan that, we have a help center with 15,000 articles. It's actually the same tool that I use. If I'm doing a demonstration with one of you and you guys say, how do I do this? And I don't know the answer, I'm secretly on my other screen going to that help center. That's literally gold right there. We're going to have a little bit of a break before our final keynote. If you have any questions for me, I'm going to be at the Level Up with Clio in the back left corner. Everyone who's made this, they're going to be in the product lab and Clio Success Center. Thank you all so much.